Right. A lot of times when you're using a spreadsheet, in this case, we're using Apple numbers, you'll encounter duplicate data. So if you want to find that duplicate data, there's a couple different ways to do it. And we'll go over a few of those in this tutorial. But first we'll start with the easiest way, right? So we're going to look at this table and we're going to try to find the duplicates. Before we do it, I will show you that there's a duplicate here. So rows 6 and 7 are duplicates and rows 17 and 18 are duplicates. Quickest way to find that out is just to select anywhere in the table. So we'll just, we'll select C3. Come over to the right-hand side, click on Organize, and we're going to add a filter. We'll do it on last name. That's a pretty good indicator of a field that should be different every time. And when you look here, it's identifying the duplicates for you. So it's saying Boynton is duplicated. There's two of them. And same is the case with Parr. All right, so that's quick and easy. If that is enough for you, then you're done. But if you need a bit more of a robust solution, so that would be you actually want to write into the cell to the right of it if it's a duplicate. We'll go over how to do that right now. And what this formula is going to do is it's going to take each row, look at it, see if it's the same as any of the rows before it. And if it is, it will write out the word duplicate. And I'll type out the formula right now. So we will hit an equal sign, which is the way that you start any formulas in Apple numbers. And we'll start out with an if, right? And now we're going to do the counting of the occurrences of these values. We'll use count ifs because we're going to check each column. So first we will check the range of A2 through A2. So we're just starting this, right? So there's actually no row above to be checking. So that's why this range is small. It looks strange at first. A2. Next we will look at column B. Then C. That's the end of our count ifs. Now we're back to the if statement. And what we're looking for is if any of those were there more than once. We'll say greater than one. And if it is greater than one, we'll return the word duplicate. So don't forget to surround it with quotes. That's what you do in a spreadsheet if you're working with text instead of a number. And then if there is a duplicate, let's just leave it blank. It's a little bit easier to see the results that way. And we'll hit enter. It looks like it's working so far because Skipper Lidden is not a blank. Oops. So we want to highlight this cell, go down to the bottom of it, and then you'll see the little yellow arrow appear. Click and hold that with your mouse, drag down, let go, and that copies the formula all the way down, and it looks like it's working. So you'll notice it does not call out the first instance because it's not duplicated yet, but it does catch the second. And that's the one that's duplicated. So that's how to identify duplicated rows in Apple numbers. In our next example, so we will go over to the right, this just two lists, and you want to see if items from one list are duplicated in the other list. All right, so what we want to do here is we're going to use a VLOOKUP formula, and this one is actually a little bit easier than the previous formula. VLOOKUP, and what VLOOKUP does is it just looks in another list to see if that value is in that list. All right, so it's pretty simple. So you need to tell it what value we're looking for. So we're going to look for the word iron. Then we're going to, and what needs to know where to look for it. So we'll say A2 through A11. Now we need to fix that range in the start and the end rows, so that it doesn't shift down as we go down. So we always want it to look at this entire list. And then the next argument is it wants to know what column to look at. You're only working with one column here, so we'll say 1. And then it needs to know whether or not to return an exact match. Well, I always just say false there. You want the exact match. We'll hit enter. So there's no value returned for iron, but as I pull this down, it returns glass and it returns stone. So if there is a duplicated value, it will pull it in this column. Now, if you don't like the error showing on there, you can always wrap this in another function called if error. And then you could say, if this is an error, then return a blank. Otherwise, then you would paste the VLOOKUP function again. But this is functional. It is showing you where the errors are. So it's accomplishing what we want while leaving the formula simple. So we'll hit the escape button to get out of there. And that's how to look up duplicate values between two tables. If you want to do it between two sheets, so let's say you're worried about duplicates over on this sheet, all you really do is change the way the cell reference works. So this next video will tell you about the different types of cell references in Apple Numbers. And thanks for watching. It's good to have you along.